Have you gotten a new air fryer and you're feeling a little bit nervous to use it? You've come to the right place. Today I'm sharing 12 common mistakes people usually make when they use an air fryer. My name is Cathy Yoder and I empower air fryer owners to save time and money by actually using their air fryer by sharing air fryer tips and tricks just like this video and a slew of air fryer recipes. Are you ready to power up your air frying game? Let's go. One of the biggest mistakes I hear from people all over the world is that they get an air fryer and then they don't use it. So if it is still in the box, it is time to get it out. Then to set yourself up for success, find a spot on your counter to store your air fryer. I promise you, once you start using it, you're gonna find out super quickly that it's totally earned that high value real estate space on your counter. It's okay to tuck it back up against the wall when you're not using it. Then when it comes time to use it, just pull it out away from the wall. That's gonna allow enough room for circulation and keep everything nice and safe. And since I have quartz countertops, I always like to have a hot pad or cutting board, some sort of trivet to set the hot air fryer basket on top of it. Now I do have an air fryer 101 video that will totally help you with your first few cooks. I'm gonna link that down in the show notes as well as the end of this video. But we've got 11 more mistakes to cover, so keep watching. The number two mistake is using oil in the wrong way. Now, yes, I want to acknowledge that air fryers are marketed as a healthy option, but in a lot of cases, you still need to use a little oil. Now, don't worry, I'm saying a little oil, not gallons of oil. We're talking like a teaspoon, at the very most, a tablespoon. And of course, in some cases, you don't need to use oil one bit. There are a few reasons that people use oil in air fryer. You've probably seen people spray the air fryer basket to keep food from sticking. If you do this, make sure you never, ever use an oil like this one. A quick look at the ingredients and you're gonna see there are chemicals and propellants in this type of oil that not only are not really great for your body, it's not good for the coating of your air fryer basket. And honestly, since air fryers do have that nonstick coating, you typically don't need to spray oil down. It's been very rare that I've had issues with food sticking to the nonstick basket. So instead of buying this store-bought cooking spray, what can you use? You can use a nice oil sprayer like this and put 100% pure oil right inside of it. It's not only healthier, but in the long run, it's cheaper as well. And the oil that I usually put in my oil sprayer is avocado oil. I just usually buy a big old bottle on Amazon or Costco, and I choose avocado oil because of its high smoke point. Now let's define smoke point. Smoke point is the temperature at which cooking oil begins to break down and produce a visible smoke coming from the food and start to degrade, which means it'll create this kind of funky flavor on the food. The smoke point of avocado oil is 520 degrees Fahrenheit or 271 degrees Celsius. So it's perfect for an air fryer that heats up anywhere between 400 and 450 degrees. And rather than submerging your food in a vat of oil, adding just a small bit of oil is gonna help your food get crispier and a nice, beautiful brown finish with a whole heck of a lot less oil. It can also help food cook more evenly and it helps your spices and seasonings stick to the food that you're air frying. Just make sure you pat your food dry before spritzing on the oil for optimal crispiness and texture. Now, when do I not use oil? If I'm baking foods like cookies, rolls, or even brownies, no need for oil. Or greasy foods like bacon, no need for oil. Pre-made frozen foods like french fries and tater tots, things like that, they already have the oils in them. You don't need to add oil. And if you're unsure whether or not you should use oil, you can always start cooking without oil. Then near the end of cook time, if you feel like you need some more browning, just lightly mist your food, crank up the heat, and it should be browned and charred perfectly. And it's okay if you don't have an oil sprayer. You could always put the food in a bowl, pour some oil over the top, and stir it around to coat all of the pieces of food. You could even just massage oil onto the meat that you're cooking if you don't have an oil sprayer like this. By the way, I have links to all of the tools that you see me using in this video down in the show notes below. Mistake number three is overcrowding the basket. You will see in a lot of marketing, they've got an abundance of french fries pouring over this air fryer basket, but those images are totally misleading. When you're air frying things like french fries or frozen vegetables or potatoes or chopped up protein, allow some room for the airflow, either by spreading food out or by making sure you don't fill the basket more than halfway. Although, do keep in mind some foods do shrink while you're air frying. For example, chicken wings, you actually could overload the basket in the beginning because these shrink as they cook and then there's plenty of room for beautiful crispy finish. If you're feeling really short on space, I do recommend getting an air fryer that's right around 6 quarts, so you have a nice amount of cooking space. Now, I do go in depth about air fryers and sizes and basket and oven style air fryers in my air fryer buying guide. So make sure you watch that next if you haven't gotten an air fryer that you're happy with yet. And this is a perfect segue into mistake number 4, which is not rotating or stirring your food while it's cooking. Just use some tongs or a spatula or even shake your basket to keep that food moving when you're about halfway to 2/3 of the way through cooking. If you have an oven style air fryer with multiple racks, just rotate those racks so each rack has a turn to be closer to the burner. Now, if you have the Cathy dual blade air fryer that has a burner on the top and the bottom, you don't have to worry about rotating your food. The 5th biggest mistake I see is when air fryer owners just use regular oven directions for their air fryer, which means they end up with way overcooked, dried out, burnt food. You see, this is the beauty of an air fryer. Because it's a mini convection oven, this small little oven heats up way faster than your traditional oven, and that's because the fan is rapidly moving hot air all around the food, so it totally speeds up the cooking process. And if you have to preheat, it'll take just a few minutes instead of like 15 minutes. So here's a simple formula. In most cases, you can adapt an oven recipe for a basket style air fryer by reducing the temperature anywhere from 10 to 25 degrees, and then you cut the cook time in half and then add more cook time as needed. And if you just need some solid air fryer recipes, well, I've got a cookbook that has more than 160 air fryer recipes in it. These have been tested and are tried true recipes that thousands of people have enjoyed. It comes in a nice, beautiful cookbook with full color pictures and a spiral binding. You can snag this at pineandpepper.co. Mistake number 6 might be one of the biggest mistakes I see people make, and it is not using an instant read meat thermometer. Did you know there are recommended internal temperatures for the perfect texture and taste, not only for proteins, but for vegetables, baked goods, and a whole lot more? Using an instant read meat thermometer is an absolute game changer with your air fryer. It's gonna help you cook your food perfectly. And guess what? I have created a free printable guide that lists out common foods with the internal temperature that you need to cook them to. Plus, there's 18 bonus tips. That just helps get everybody in the household on the same page. After you print this guide out, just hang it in a cabinet right above your air fryer, and then you have it ready for quick and easy reference, so you have success with your instant read meat thermometer and whatever you're cooking in the air fryer. You can get this free download at internaltemperaturechart.com, and the instant read meat thermometer can be found at airfryertools.com. And P.S. very soon, you can get this instant read meat thermometer and my entire product line at pineandpepper.co. That is my new online store, and I'm so excited about it. Mistake number 7, I hear about people scrubbing their air fryer basket and ruining it, or not even cleaning it at all. My friends, cleaning your air fryer does not have to be complicated, and it takes just a few minutes. Now, I have an entire video where I really break down the whole cleaning and maintenance process. I will link to that down in the show notes. But basically, all you need to do is let your air fryer basket cool down, wipe out the food with paper towel, spray it with some Dawn Power Wash, and let it sit for a few minutes, then wipe it down one more time and rinse it out. For a little heavier duty cleaning, I love to use these nice, soft, velvety cloths. They do a fantastic job, and they are linked down in the show notes as well. And by the way, if your air fryer smells like stinky plastic, I've got a solution for that in my air fryer cleaning video as well. Mistake number 8 is not using parchment paper to prevent nasty messes in your air fryer and to make lifting food out of the air fryer a lot easier. I love using this air fryer parchment paper for times where it's just gonna get really messy in my air fryer. When I'm using messy ingredients like cheese or eggs, I also love using it so I can remove things like rolls, cookies, nachos, and I've also used it to cook brownies in it. If you do use parchment paper, just a couple of things you need to be aware of. Never put parchment paper in your air fryer basket and then preheat it. Even though this paper is oven safe, you don't need that fan blowing it right up into the burner, because it'll start singeing the parchment paper. So instead, if you do preheat it, go ahead and preheat it, then set the parchment paper in, and then make sure your food is evenly spread all over the parchment paper to hold it down. Otherwise, corners will blow up and not only cover your food, but they might also touch the burner. And guess what? I'm so excited to announce that I have my very own parchment paper now. You can snag it at my online store, pineandpepper.co. Mistake number 9, I see people using their air fryer for nothing more than french fries or chicken nuggets or frozen foods. And I'm so sad for them because they are totally missing out. My friends, you can cook a ton of different things in the air fryer. Things like bacon, chicken, veggies, marinated meats, grilled cheese. You could even use it to reheat leftovers. Yes, reheating leftovers in the air fryer will take 3 to 5 minutes at 350 degrees, so a little bit longer than the 30 seconds in your microwave, but I guarantee you, it will resurrect your food and make it taste amazing, unlike the microwave oven. At the end of this video, I will link to another video that is chock full of delicious, uncommon air fryer foods. Mistake number 10 is when people use the wrong tools in their air fryer. Never use metal forks or tongs or spatulas. You don't want to scrape up your air fryer basket. Instead, invest in some silicone tongs or spatulas, and that's going to protect your investment. And also, don't forget, anything that can be used in an oven could also be used in your air fryer. So no, you're not going to put plastic in your air fryer, but you can put metal things in your air fryer or oven safe glass dishes. I also love to use little ramekins or silicone muffin liners. This is totally going to broaden what you can do with your air fryer. Mistake number 11 is cooking fatty foods wrong. If you're air frying things like bacon or chicken thighs or steak, you're going to find that the beauty of the air fryer is that all of the drippings go beneath the air fryer tray, but in some air fryers, that can create a big smoking issue that might even set off smoke alarms. So instead, in order to absorb the grease, I like to put a slice of bread right under the tray, then all of the drippings go right into that, and it will resolve the issue of the smoke alarm going off. P.S. My bacon lover friends, I got lots of comments that suggest you just toast up that bacon grease bread and make it into croutons, which apparently is amazing. Mistake number 12 is air frying wet foods. Number one, you always want to pat your food dry. That's going to give you nice crispy results. And because the air fryer is not a deep fryer, foods with wet batters aren't going to do well because they're not hitting that nice flash of hot grease. Now, if you're ready to start air frying, these recipes right here are perfect for the new air fryer owner. And if you're still feeling nervous, watch my air fryer 101 right here. This is my air fryer buying guide, and there's a lot more links down in the description box. Thank you for watching. I will see you on the next video.